but other than that.
We're talking to one of the best trainers in boxing. He makes champions, Ronnie Shields, maybe trainer of the year 2016, phenomenal year. What can we look forward to in 2017?
Well, one thing you're going to look forward to is Jamal Charlo moving up to middleweight.
Wow.
You know, we got to go up, man. We gave up the belt. And, you know, now he's going to fight in May or June, you know.
That division is deep. Do you want to see him fight the winner of Triple G Jacobs? Do you want to see him fight the winner of Canelo Chavez Jr.?
No, what I wanted him to do first, I wanted him to get a feel of the division first. You know, so that's what we're going to do first. You know, we're going to do that first. And once we get the feel of the division, then, you know, I mean, I want to see him take a top 15 guy first. And then after that, we're going to move on from there, see how he feels. If he feels great, then we're going to go on express run.
They say you can't teach power, and he has tremendous power. And people maybe underrated even. They don't even realize how strong he is. Tell us about when you do miss with them or hit body shots, how bad do you feel it?
Hey, man, the kid is strong. You know, and it's a natural thing. You know, that's something you can't build. So he's a natural, just naturally, you know, a strong guy. And, you know, we just look forward to working with him all the time. Such a great guy.
He's a great kid, too. And yes, he got a bad rap last time. But, hey, the emotions, it's boxing.
Absolutely.
You leave it alone, you move on. Amir Khan, Manny Pacquiao are saying they're negotiating. Break down the fight.
Well, you know what? You know, Pacquiao has been the more active fighter. And, you know, Pacquiao's a really good boxer. Amir Khan, he can punch. You know, that's one thing he has. And Pacquiao don't get hit that much.
So,
you know, close fight, but I say Pacquiao by decision.
Okay, talk about this one. Chavez Jr., who you're very familiar with, Canelo, who you're very familiar with, they're actually in Houston today, but break down the fight.
Good fight, man. I really like it. I think if Chavez Jr. stick to his guns and boxes, I don't see him losing this fight.
You're one of the few to say that. Why? You know boxing, right? Well, you've been around the sport your whole life.
Yeah, you know, I know Chavez Jr. can box. You know, I've seen it. And I know what he can do, you know, because I've seen him. You know, the first river fight, I know he wasn't in that great position. But he proved it the second fight with River that, you know, when he puts his mind to it, he can box, he can come forward, he can do it. And I know he was in much better shape the second fight than he was the first fight. So, but, you know, but look, I like Canelo. Canelo can punch, but, you know, sometimes it takes more than a punch. You know, sometimes you got to jab every now and then for it to happen. You know, you can't disrespect for a guy to stand in front of you and not throw punches back. And Chavez can punch a little bit. So, I like Chavez.
If Chavez wins, you will not be shocked, but the whole world will be shocked.
The whole world may be shocked, but I won't be shocked. I really think Chavez is going to win.
Okay, let me ask you about one more fight. Danny Jacobs, Triple G.
You know, Danny's my boy.
The great kid.
Look, if Danny could just stick to the guns and box, stay on the outside, I think he can really win this fight. It's a strong possibility. That's the way he can do it. You know, that's the way he has to do it. You know, to prove no point going in and trying to go toe-to-toe with a guy that can punch with both hands. So, if he can stick to his guns and stay on the outside, he has a strong possibility. But I think once it gets heated up, though, fighting in New York, you know, Danny's going to want to prove that he can hang. And I just don't see him winning. I really don't. As much as I want him to, I just don't see it.
Okay, Lomachenko, Rigondeaux, if they fight. Which I don't think, if it did happen. Two gold members versus two gold members.
If it did happen, I have to go with Rigondeaux. You know, Rigondeaux is a phenomenal boxer. You know, Lomachenko would have to make the fight. Rigondeaux would make him make the fight. Because he was still on the outside. He don't care about the crowd booing. He don't care about what anybody think. You know, Lomachenko does. So he would have to try to make the fight. And that's the wrong thing against a guy like Guillermo Rigondeaux.
Okay, last fight I'm going to ask you about. Danny Garcia, Keith Thurman, March 4th, New York City. Somebody's all got to go. You're smiling, but it's a great fight. It's great for boxing.
It's a great fight, man. It's a better than a great fight. You know, I'm glad to see this fight happen. You know, my gut says Thurman, but in boxing reality, I have to go with Danny Garcia.
Now, Ronnie, you had a great year last year. You made a champion. You defended it, if I'm not mistaken, as well, right?
Yes.
If people tell you you're trainer of the year, what's your response?
Hey, man, you know, I'm not in this sport to get accolades. You know, my thing is, this is my job. This is how I take care of my family. And, hey, you know, award. I like the reward better than the award.
Now, Errol Spence, what do you think about him? Oscar De La Hoya said yesterday he's better than Floyd Mayweather.
Well, you know, Errol is a really good fighter. Love Errol to death. Great guy, you know. And I don't see a lot of people beating him. I really don't. You know, this guy, he's the real deal. And, you know, but you prove it in the ring. And that's what he's been doing over and over and over again. And I don't see him stop doing it.
Okay, he's fighting Kell Brook. Does he knock him out? Decision?
Well, I think going to England, he has to really beat him up back.
You know, even if you beat someone up out there, if they're still standing,
absolutely.
Like Ray Beltran when he fought Ricky Burns, broke his jaw, dropped him, still got a draw.
Absolutely. So, but I think Errol knocked him out. I really do.
All right, Ronnie Shield, thank you so much. Good luck this weekend, and we'll see you soon. This is the Point.com Vice Squad reporting.